welcome everyone to this week's version of Facebook Live. Today we're going to talk about the Hall of Fame of some of the good campaigns and some of the bad campaigns. And today's guest, he's a newcomer to the show, first time, surprisingly. This is Luke. He runs our customer success team and has all the data inside that magical head of his to kind of talk about today. So we're excited to be here. To start things off, Luke, wanted to discuss what are the characteristics of a good campaign?
It's a great question. Really, when you're looking at a good campaign, there's three or four things that I would recommend, and I do recommend all the clients I talk to. Number one is making sure you include your business name so that they know who the promotion is coming from. Number two is some kind of promotion, some kind of offer so that there's something to drive traffic, something to drive customers to want to come in. The third thing is a sense of urgency, making sure that you have an expiration date. It's not too far out there. I get a lot of clients that want to put an expiration date around a promotion for like 3 or 4 months. The challenge when you do a 3 or 4 month promotion is what I think when I see that and I get that on my phone is I look at it and I'm like, oh yeah, this is awesome. Oh, I really want to go in here. It's good for 2 weeks. Cool. I'll go next week, or I'll go in two or three days, or this weekend. And then I forget about it. And so like it doesn't drive me in there, and so that's why we want to make sure that we create that sense of urgency and put an expiration date. I usually recommend 3 to 4 days, 2 to 3 days, as late as a week, and it could go longer. We'll talk about a few things I'll recommend with that, but I definitely recommend a shorter campaign. And then the fourth thing is with the promotion that you put in there is when you get a text message, there's a certain little preview. There's a little bit of of what shows up before you open the text message, mm-hmm. including that promotion at the very beginning, the call of action, so that the customer will see that and it will drive them into your store and get them excited to actually want to open up that text message or want to find out what's going on.
So putting the call of action right at the beginning, because you're right, technology these days, cell phones are very, very similar in the fact that you all get that brief sentence, and you can see the first like couple words of that text message. So yeah, put that call of action right there. That way also when they're scrolling through their phone, they can remember it and see it. It's right there at the beginning. And then the only thing I'd add to that is just relevancy. When you're creating a campaign,
absolutely,
sending out messages from your account, having relevancy, making sure that it's just it's relevant to your consumers, or else they're going to ignore it and continue to ignore your messages unless each time they see them, it's relevant, gets them excited, has a promotion on it, has something that's important to them. So something such as, it doesn't always have to be a promotion. Sometimes it could be, we're closed today because the weather's bad. Mm-hmm. Sometimes your customers want to know that. And we see those type of messages all the time. But we mentioned promotions, and that's a whole other element. I mean, there's a lot of discussion that we can have about what goes into good promotion. But yeah, give us some thoughts about promotions and what makes a good promotion and what really drives traffic into your store.
Really with driving traffic and a good promotion is going to be based upon that relevancy that you talked about. Something that's going to get them excited about it, perceive the value. Depending on what the promotion is you're trying to create the most value that the customer is going to be the most excited. Really depending on your type of business. If you're a restaurant business, I was in restaurant management for many years. That could be something as simple as if you're doing pizza as breadsticks. Breadsticks have a high perceived value but a low actual cost. The same thing when you're dealing with drinks, soft drinks, sodas, things like that, desserts. Usually you have a higher profit margin with those things. If you're in a shaved ice shack, even just an upsize, going from a medium size to a large size, if you're shaved ice or flavored soda, that's a high perceived value that you're going to be able to drive traffic a lot better with those. Frozen yogurt places, doing flat rates for your cups, or a no way type of scenario, no way Wednesday, I've seen that out a lot. But really being able to give them a high perceived value, being able to do something that is unique. I saw a campaign, it was just last month actually, the campaign was National High Five Day. Mm-hmm. National High Five Day, come in, we'll give you $5 off your purchase, of $20 or more, whatever it might be. But it's something unique that is different. And so it creates a little bit of buzz, and people go around all day long like, oh yeah, hey, do you know it's National High Five Day? Hey, give me a high five. Just something simple like that, you're able to really create some viral aspect to it that people start talking about it. But definitely something that's relevant, something that's unique. The wording of your campaign is another thing that I find huge. When you're doing a buy one, get one free, or a buy one, get one 50% off, when you mention it that way, a BOGO 50, or as commonly said, it creates a value behind it. But if you were to actually change the wording around and say, get a free entree with purchase of another entree or something like that, the very first and beginning is like, oh, I can get a free entree. And so people get more excited about it. So really looking at the wording, that's going to be a huge thing to create that perceived value. The final thing I would probably recommend is really doing a multiple day offer. Okay. I get a lot of clients that want to send out, hey, we have a one day offer today only, which is great, which works great. And it creates that sense of urgency. And it's fantastic if you're having a slower day or a rainy day and you're really trying to boost sales for one day. But when I look at different analytics for different campaigns, what I saw is that we can increase, 2 or 3% redemption rate, or even on some of them doubling the redemption rate if we're doing a 2 or 3 day offer. Just because as myself, I'm driving down the road and I get a text, as I mentioned earlier, I think, oh, well, I can do it later on. Or if I get a text and it's like, oh, shoot, well, I already have plans tonight. I already have this I'm doing. And so it provides that opportunity for me to go the next day, but it's short enough. It creates that sense of urgency to try and help drive me in.
Yeah, I think you're right regarding that. I think immediately, some people just can't do it that day. But within 2 or 3 days, that sense of urgency still remains there. I can make a mental plan that I need to go redeem this coupon. I like a lot of things that you said. You mentioned making it creative. I think that's a great thing to do, making sure that it stands out above the rest, so that you will remember it. The expiration day, 2 or 3 days out. And then the word free, that's a buzz. Generally speaking, we have, there's a variety of companies that they use us. And generally speaking, if you can get the word free in there, you're going to increase your redemption rate when you send out a message. And so make sure to do that and get that perceived value up as high as you can. Those are definitely great things. Just want to ask you, we've seen a lot of messages go through. Is there any mistakes that people are making too often, or anything that we shouldn't be doing that is happening just too often right now?
Unfortunately, there are. Now, we try and help coach clients through as they call in, and we'll assist them in the wording of the message and making sure it's actually a relevant campaign. Whereas I worked with a lot of clients, and I've actually told them, I honestly think that you could do better if you were to change this. And we have a whole Account Pro staff that's designed and we've trained to help you be able to optimize your message and optimize the redemption rate. But we also have the ability for business owners to send out the promotions on their own or the campaigns on their own. And so in doing that, I've seen everything, even with ones that we've assisted with. We're not perfect by any means. But if there's no promotion that's attached to it, if they just send out kind of an informational thing, but that's good. And what you mentioned earlier, if you're closed, if there's weather and you're not able to be open that day, because I went yesterday to a store and it wasn't until I got to the store that there was a sign on the door that said, hey, we're closed today.
Right.
And so nothing's more frustrating than you going all that distance to find out that they're closed. But when you're sending out a promotion, if it's not relevant, or taking a step backwards, if you're not sending out any kind of promotion, but you're just sending out a message that doesn't have any kind of promotion or any information behind it, those are things that aren't as effective. When the promotion doesn't necessarily apply to me or it doesn't have any perceived value. Now, every time you send out a campaign, you're not going to always have something that will apply to everybody.
Sure.
But at the same time, you don't want to send out repeated campaigns that don't apply. We have the ability within our system that you can actually segregate your database and separate so that you're only sending out to relative contacts or ones that apply, that certain filters apply to it or that would be relevant too. So we do have that ability to filter those out, but really making sure that it's something that it applies to them. It doesn't require a lot on their part. There was a campaign a few months ago that was sent out by a client in December time, ugly sweater. That's a huge popular thing. Mm-hmm. But when you require a customer to go and actually do a particular action, to be able to get a promotion, it's really going to be the perceived value that will drive that. A lot of clients don't want to, or a lot of customers don't want to do something to be able to receive the promotion. They just want to show up and get it.
Unless it's super easy, like a high five that anyone could do.
Exactly.
But yeah, if you're requiring people to go home, change, get into an ugly sweater, and come in, you better have a really good reward at the end of that. I mean, I know Chick-fil-A gets away with it with their dress as a cow and come in and get a free entree. That's a really good value, and people are dressed as cows everywhere, and that kind of virality goes out there, but not every brand can demand that. And so be sensitive to what kind of brand you are and if it's going to have that effect. But yeah, it's got to be good value if you're going to make people do something to it.
Exactly. It's a perceived value. I mean, they're getting a free sandwich when they do that on that particular day. Whereas if you're just offering something, you know, whether it's 10% off if you do this, it's the perceived value that really makes a huge difference. And so as you look at that and as you send out these campaigns, make sure it's a campaign that you would actually want to go into that business or your business, that's going to drive you to want to go in there is really the big question that I drive business owners to ask themselves is, would this drive you to go into your store if you weren't the owner?
Yeah, I've seen before at a yogurt shop, a 5% off promotion, and I just had a laugh. I said, no, that's not going to budget. If it's 5% off a cart, great. But if it's 5% off something of small value, that's not going to drive the needle for me. And so make sure that value is there. But make sure you're also calculating your own ROI and not making it too aggressive. Find that perfect line in between what's too aggressive and what's going to drive the needle and make sure that you're getting that investment back from sending out that campaign. Well, one thing I know our audience would be really interested in is your, I know your team looks at and studies different case studies and to find out what's working, what's not. Is there any particular ones that come to mind that you could would be beneficial for our audience?
Great question. Really, as I mentioned before, with having these different elements that make this successful campaign, the sense of urgency, the incentive or the promotion, your business name so they know where to go, limiting it to a 2 or 3 day promotion.
Okay.
If you want to go longer, you can do longer. I mean, we'll help you do whatever you're looking at doing. I would recommend sending out a follow-up campaign. We've seen a lot of success if we do like a 2 week promotion, maybe a week before it ends, anyone that hasn't redeemed it, say, don't forget, or even a day before it ends, don't forget, $1 off, $3 off, whatever the promotion is, expires tomorrow. Be sure to come in before it expires.
Just to go off of that, some industries, it's hard to get away with that 2 or 3 day expiration.
Absolutely.
Because haircuts. For example, I have to be in the right cycle to get my haircut, and so longer redemption might make a little bit more sense. But setting that reminder somewhere between when I got it and at the end creates that urgency again.
Yep.
And still get that
Yep.
value out of it.
Oil changes, same type of thing. You're
Yep.
not always going to go in at a certain time, so sending out that reminder message, huge success in that. Honestly, we've seen a huge success in sending out our automated drip campaigns right after. We have a few clients that like to send it right after, which they see a huge success in. Being you leave the business, they send out a promotion, hey, how was your race today? Or hey, how was this event? How did you do? We'd love to see you back. Come back this week and we'll give you $10 off. We'll give you $5 off. But even just a promotion just the week after. We saw, when I was looking through some different statistics, I was able to see the highest redemption rate actually happening 7 days after the promotion went out. Not promotion went out, but 7 days after they initially visited the store, they were able to drive customers
Gotcha.
Back
so,
in by sending
so,
them that promotion.
If you're going to do a bounce back promotion, they'll probably, I mean, make it at least 7 days in that instance because that's when they come back. Is that what you're saying?
Not necessarily make it 7 days, but reach out to them within that 7 days.
Okay, gotcha.
Whether it's the day after or just within that 7 days, it's a lot easier to drive a customer back into your store when they've already been there and they understand your product and
yeah.
what it is.
Especially if they had a good experience that time, they'll remember that and they'll bring, you know, top of mind awareness is what we always talk about in marketing, and that will get them right back thinking, oh, that dessert was awesome.
Absolutely.
Let me go this week.
Absolutely. Even, you know, sending out some kind of referral campaign, trying to drive them in once they had the experience of your business, have them refer their friends and try and leave a review on social media, whatever it might be. But have them do that right after they've been into your business because they remember how it is and they remember the service, they remember how much fun they had, and you're going to be able to drive them back in and get them to offer those different things a lot easier.
Yeah, because we do a lot of review campaigns where we're getting people to review on on different networks, Facebook, Google, etc. Yeah, that's a campaign that you want to create that relevancy. You want to do it right after they visit. If you just do it some random time, it's not going to be as effective. So yeah, we didn't even get into those type of campaigns really today, but mainly the promotion side of it all. But yeah, a lot of great campaigns out there, and it's been great. Is there any other things that you wanted to mention today before wrapping it up?
You know, honestly, I know we talked about a lot of different things. Really, the most important thing is that you're reaching out to your consumers. I mean, there's so many different businesses, whether you're just collecting business cards because you have every intention of reaching out to them, or you're even utilizing our City Grow kiosk to be able to capture your customers' information. But if you're not reaching out to them, you can't drive the customers back. So the most important thing I would say is reach out to your customers, communicate with them, and then outside of that, when you do send out campaigns, test it out. You're not going to have the most successful campaign necessarily the first time you send one. So send one, try it out, see what kind of redemption rate you get. Talk to our customer success team here. We're happy to help you. And then send out another one, you know, a week or 2 weeks later. Just see what works for your business and your demographics. And by all means, just reach out and communicate with your customers.
Yeah, the last thing to go off what you just said is talk to our customer success team. They're willing to help. We have people dedicated towards helping people come up with different promotions. They're not experts in the field sometimes, and so we want to be the expert for you. Feel free to give us a call, and we'd be happy to help schedule anything, or even if you're not a customer of ours and just want some advice, feel free to call. We'd love to talk, and we love talking about campaigns. So thanks, Luke, for joining us.
Absolutely.
This week, and we'll see you next week. Take care.